Good morning students, I am Vetri Chelvi from Vetri and Vetri Neat Chemistry. Today I am going to give the video topic is tautomerism. So far I have completed three isomerism videos over. Each videos are very important. So far I have completed some 76 videos, but proportionately my subscriber number is very less. So I request my students, everybody please convey to your friends or your juniors, 11th standard student, if you think the 12th is not your competitor, I mean, better you convey to the 11th standard student, make them to utilize my videos. It will be much helpful for me also. Let us go to the topic is tautomerism. Okay, now the tautomerism knowledge is point number one. Keto-enol tautomerism, that is functional group, keto group with the enol, alcohol group and keto group. Okay, now the condition is the compound must have the at least one alpha hydrogen or it may have acidic hydrogen can show that what is it called tautomerism. So next condition, which are the compound may not show mean the kind of compound which are not having alpha hydrogen. So what is the point is the compound should have alpha hydrogen. The different knowledge is here is either the alpha hydrogen or the important point is acidic hydrogen. Okay, ma'am. So condition is alpha hydrogen should be present, at least one. Next one is, second is this very important point, carboxylic acid and their derivatives except the acid amide cannot show the tautomerism. That meaning only the amide is showing the tautomerism, the acid and the derivative. What are the derivatives of acid means ester and then what is it called anhydride, ester, anhydride and then acids. These are then only next one you can call it as a acid chloride. For the acid you are having four derivatives. One is you can call it acid, another is ester, another is anhydride, another is acid chloride, another is amide. So among the four, the amide only showing the what is it called tautomerism. Others are, for example, ester, acid chloride are not showing the keto enol tautomerism. This point is very important. Then the last point is regarding is the tautomeric form must be geometrically favorable. That is meaning is after forming the isomerism, the product should be stable. Otherwise, if it is not stable, mean the isomerism will not be resulted. So this is the third point. With that, I am entering into the topic of your tautomerism. Which of the following compound will not go the tautomerism? They are asking, will not go the, what is the condition is the compound should have the alpha hydrogen. Let us see, will not go mean, we will see which are not having the alpha hydrogen. The first one, what about this is the functional group OH, point number one. This is not having keto. That means you have to think in other direction, that I will come afterwards. Now coming here, keto group, this is your alpha where you are having, this is your CH2 is available, alpha hydrogen is available, so it is answering. And here what is it called as a, this is the functional group, both places alpha hydrogen is not available, no alpha hydrogen, so it is not able to answer. What they are asking, which will not undergo tautomerism is, so direct knowledge, this is not answering. So no alpha hydrogen, not answering. So this is your answer. I am correcting. This is your answer. Let us see what about here. This one. Here you are having the double bond, your keto form is there. And here both side you are having methyl group, but here one more, the fourth valence is balanced by hydrogen. So you are having alpha hydrogen is there. So it is answering. This is the answering tautomerism. Now whatever happened, this is for this the knowledge is it is not keto form, but with a tricky manner they have given the enolic form. So now with that I am starting the enolic form you are getting from the keto form. That is the knowledge I want to insist. How you are getting is remove. Now I am doing back work of tautomerism. Now you remove hydrogen. So this bonding shifting here and this bonding shifting here, the hydrogen is moving. So now let me write what is happening is double bond O, and here you are having the hydrogen. And what happened? Yes, that's all. So now this one, now or I can give the diagram of like this. So we are having the alpha hydrogen. So this is also responded due to tautomerism. The enolic form is given. So anyhow, enolic form will be go to keto form. Keto will come back to the enolic form. So here it is instead of reactant, the product is available. So all the three are responding the tautomerism. This is only not answering because no alpha hydrogen. Okay, children, very beautiful question. Now let us see the again. I am coming. Which of the following compound will not undergo tautomerism? This is the answer because no alpha hydrogen. Here tricky is it is not keto, it is enol. So how the enol is coming from the keto? The work is done. So that is also responding. So answer is D. Now let us go to the next question based on the tautomerism. Tautomerism topic is very important, very easy also. Now let us see the question. Which of the given compound can exist tautomerism? This is the can exist. Okay, now let us see. Each one we will see. Here the double one keto group. Okay, on both side you are watching 1, 2, 3. Here it is. You are having alpha, sufficiently alpha hydrogen. So it is answering. It is alpha hydrogen. So now it is alpha hydrogen answering tautomerism. Here the same thing, alpha hydrogen, so it is answering. Now here double bond O, here it is you are having the what is it called, no alpha hydrogen. Here 1, 2, 3, of course here hydrogen is there, so this will be answering, but not as others, but in this place we can expecting when this is in between the alpha, or there is alpha and beta, instead of this the hydrogen atom here will be coming for the tautomerism. That is called as the paratautomerism. That knowledge I will give here. What is paratautomerism? Is double bond present between the alpha and beta position of cyclic ketone. You will see each by word. Cyclic ketone, where the double bond is present between alpha and beta position, hydrogen of carbon 4 will be take part in the tautomerism is called as a 1,5 or paratautomerism. Now let us see, come and apply the knowledge. It is cyclic ketone and the double bond is present between alpha beta. You can see here double bond present alpha and beta, double bond is present alpha and beta, and double bond is alpha and beta. So in this case I am not that much particular because this alpha hydrogen is available. In this case also this alpha hydrogen is available. In this case of course this hydrogen is available, but more pronounced this hydrogen, the hydrogen here is coming for the isomerism under the topic of paratautomerism. So this is also answering the tautomerism with a little different knowledge. So your answer is 1, 2, and 3. All the three are answering the tautomerism. Okay, now I am moving to the next knowledge. The knowledge is here. Return is percentage of enolic form. Usually the keto form, if it is simple keto means keto form is more stable than the enolic form. Now the point is given, percentage of enol, that means when the enol is more stable. Here the condition is when you are having the complex structure like 1,3 diketo, that is two ketones are available, position is 1,3, that is labeled as complex structure. In that category enol form is more stable. Keep it in mind children, always keto is more stable when it is simple. When it is complex, enol is more stable. What is complex? Two keto groups are arranged is called it as a complex. So in complex enol is more stable. The reason is due to the resonance and the intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Two reasons they are given. One point is resonance, another point is intramolecular hydrogen bonding. We will see the example. Okay, now let us see the first question. Here, this is the question. Yes. Question is, which of the following compound has the highest enol content? Okay, point number one, all are having diketone, so complex, all are enolic form is stable. Here, let us see one by one. Here it is, here simply it is given mean, what is the meaning? Yes, it is both are methyl group. Here it is one methyl, one phenyl group. Here two phenyl group. Here again you are having the one, two methyl group. So now comparing all these things, here one phenyl group, because of that you are having resonant three number. Here you are having two phenyl group, so they are having the more resonating structure, so most stable. Point number one. Next, once the enol is formed in between, enol formed, mean this in between, that is a formation of intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So both reason, this enolic form is more stable than the others comparatively. Let us go and see the last question of today's section is the same knowledge. The order of stability of the following tautomeric compound. Here you are provided the compound number 1, compound number 2 and compound number 3. Now let me go one by one. I am taking the first, writing them compound number 2. You follow please here. My compound, just I am writing here, of course, you need not worry. This is compound number 2. From there, I can bring the compound 1 as well as compound 3. So, this is the ketone. It is going to follow the tautomerism. Here, this is the alpha hydrogen. Now, in this case, I am going to take this one. I am taking this. Let me write this carbon hydrogen I am taking as a. So, followed by the A. So, what is happening here? The hydrogen you are moving, bond is shifting. Okay, let me write. And this is moving. Yes, CH3. Same, single bond OH, double bond CH, C double bond O, CH3. So now this hydrogen, what is the speciality is, this hydrogen is more acidic. And in between you are having intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So because of the two reasons, your three is, this enolic form is excellent in, I am telling it is the excellent in stability. Okay, now let us go to the one. Let us see the one. In the case of one, I am labeling this hydrogen as a B. So this is less, this hydrogen is less B, which is less acidic compared with this hydrogen. So now move this is one, this hydrogen here one hydrogen is moving, bond is shifting. CH2, double bond C. Here hydrogen is moving, here OH. Remaining on, there is no change at all. You can write as it is. So this is the first enolic form. But what is this enolic form? But because of this is least stable. That is the point I want to stress. Okay, now excellent is put it 3. And the order, I saw all the order of this one. Options, you see the option, this, so I am putting this is, so excellent 3 is excellent, next the stability is 2, next then it is the 1. Let us go and see the option, your option is B, so put that in. So what is here knowledge? Take the keto form, complete, convert into the enolic form, among the enol which is more stable, based on that we are completing the answer. Thank you children.